Okay, let's quickly review the lift and the drag for a minute. Okay, so this is something that you should be familiar with, but we're going to go over it a little bit to refresh your memory. So let's consider the lift and drag on a glider or an aircraft that does not have power. Okay, so there's no thrust. All right, so we'll start out with the lift. Now, the lift we generally talk about in terms of a lift coefficient. All right, and the lift coefficient is simply the lift divided by 1/2 rho, which is the free stream density, v squared, which is the free stream velocity, and then we generally non-dimensionalize this by the area of the main wing, or S sub w. Okay? Now, in steady level flight, the lift has to equal the weight. So we can equivalently write this as weight divided by 1/2 rho v squared sw. Okay, and we sometimes will call this also the weight coefficient because we've simply non-dimensionalized the weight. Okay, now let's talk about drag for a second. Okay, so again, drag we usually talk about in terms of a drag coefficient, which is drag divided by 1/2 rho v squared sw. And now the drag has two parts, if you'll remember. There is an inviscid part, or an induced drag coefficient, and there is a parasitic drag coefficient. So the induced drag coefficient is, sorry, I'm just going to make this a little more clear. Okay, so the drag coefficient is equal to the induced drag coefficient plus a parasitic drag coefficient. Now, the parasitic drag comes from things like viscosity or form drag, things like that. Okay? Induced drag is drag induced by the lift only. So let's talk a little bit about parasitic drag for a second. Okay? So parasitic drag. So if you'll think back for a minute, parasitic drag is generally very nearly parabolic with angle of attack and lift coefficient. Okay, so what this means is if we, I'm going to use a different color here to talk about parasitic drag. If we write the parasitic drag coefficient, or CDP, as a function of the lift coefficient, then we'll get something that looks like a parabola. So we'll have a CDP naught plus CDP naught L, let's see, times CL plus CDP naught L squared times CL squared. Okay? So you can see this is the form of a parabola in the lift coefficient, where CDP naught, CDP naught L, and CDP naught L squared are simply coefficients that make the, I guess they're like fit coefficients, okay? All right, let's scroll down a little bit here. Okay, so the way this looks on a plot, sorry, I'm going to do that in white instead. Okay, so it'll look something like this, where here we have the lift coefficient, here we have the drag co CDP, we'll say, parasitic drag coefficient, and the drag will look something like this. Okay, so there's a point here where zero drag happens. Or I guess not zero drag, but minimum drag, and it is not always the point where we have zero lift. Okay, so that's that would be this term here that changes that. Okay, so that's kind of what it looks like. All right, now the induced drag for a twisted wing is going to look a little bit different. So I'm going to do this now in let me write it first. Induced drag. Put a line. Okay, now I'm going to do this in red. Okay, we're going to talk about induced drag in red. So the induced drag, let's leave parasitic drag up there. Okay, so the induced drag, if you'll think back to Prandtl's lifting line theory, we can write the induced drag like this. So CDI, which is the induced drag coefficient, is equal to CL squared over pi ESRA. So hopefully this should be a review for you. Now this is the induced drag coefficient on an untwisted wing. Okay, so notice again that we are parabolic in CL. We have CL squared here. And then we have pi, and then this right here is what's known as the span efficiency factor. Okay. And this is different than the Oswald efficiency factor, which we'll talk about in just a second. Okay, so that's important. And then, of course, RA is the aspect ratio of the wing. Okay, now we can write total drag as a sum of the parasitic drag and the induced drag. So I'm going to do this in green. Okay, so CD, well, let's go a little higher here. CD total is going to be CDI plus CDP. And this is really easy to do because we have a term here with CL squared and a term here with CL squared. So the way this looks then is I'm going to come all the way down here so I have a little more space. So CD total is going to be CD naught plus CD naught L CL. And then we're going to have plus 1 over pi ERA. CL squared. Okay? Now, CD naught and CD naught L, we've just brought those straight down. We just renamed them, okay? Because we're talking about total drag now. Again, they're just coefficients. But you can see that we've now changed this from CL squared over pi ESRA to 1 over, or CL squared over pi ERA. Okay, so now we're talking about the Oswald efficiency factor. And the difference is that the Oswald efficiency factor factors in our CDP not L squared. Okay? Do you see how that works? So what happens then if we have a wing that is twisted? Okay, so just to kind of recap here, we said the parasitic drag coefficient is nearly parabolic with lift coefficient. And the induced drag coefficient is CL squared over pi ESRA. Now, this is strictly only true for untwisted wings. But what you'll find is that most aerodynamicists will call that good. They'll say, okay, well, we have the induced drag coefficient for an untwisted wing. Let's just go ahead and run with that and call it good. But in reality, the induced drag coefficient is, it changes when we have a twist in the wing, which, to be honest, is the vast majority of most wings. So let's take a look at what that is. So the induced drag coefficient for a wing with twist in it looks something like this. We'll have kappa d omega times, sorry, let me rewrite that. It's kind of ugly. Okay, let's try this again. Kappa d omega times CL alpha times omega quantity squared divided by pi RA minus kappa D L times CL, CL alpha, say CL alpha times omega divided by pi RA all times CL plus 1 plus kappa D divided by pi RA times CL squared. Okay, now I'm not going to go into detail about what all these things mean, but I just want to point out that your kappa D, so your kappa D omega, your kappa D L, and your kappa D are all functions of the Fourier coefficients in the lifting line solution. And the capital omega is the it's like the magnitude of your twist. It's a scaling factor for your twist. And pi RA and CL alpha, of course, we recognize. The other thing I wanted to point out is we've written this a little bit different. So before we did CL squared over pi ES RA. Here we've written 1 plus kappa D over pi RA times CL squared. That is because this 1 plus kappa D is the same. So 1 plus kappa D is the same as 1 divided by the span efficiency factor. Okay? All right, well, the total drag coefficient then, as we did before, is the parasitic drag coefficient plus the induced drag coefficient. So let's just put these together. So what we're going to do then is, once again, we're going to create a new coefficient that we're going to call CD naught. And CD naught is just CDP naught plus this first term here. Okay, and then we'll do the same with CD naught L. So that's CDP naught L plus this second term, which of course has a minus in front, times CL. And then we'll combine these last two, but here again we want to include the Oswald efficiency factor, so we're going to write it this way. We're going to call it CL squared, we'll do it this way, 1 over pi E RA times CL squared, where E now, of course, is the Oswald efficiency factor. Now notice this is exactly the same as when we had CD induced drag with an untwisted wing. We haven't changed the form of this at all. The only difference here is that our CD naught and CD naught L are now different than they were before because they include terms relating to the twist. Okay, so we're going to use this equation here for drag throughout. And I just want to be clear that as we use it, it will include twist.